erfahren.
Write something if you are here.
Oh wait, I'll try it again. Well, that's so.
What's going on, the underscore Nathan underscore L fans?
Hello, Shan Yang Gang. Are you somebody that has come before under another name or not? Otherwise, you're not much use, really. So this is more about. What I want now is somebody that's come on many times, and I want to basically do a thing. I don't really know what to say at this point. Is the audio? Yeah, the audio seems to be working. Otherwise, I can just go on and talk about stuff generally.
I've been here long ago.
You've been here long ago. Under another name. And who are you? What was your name when you were? Do you remember what your name was? When you're long ago. Is there anything you want to discuss since you're here? Like I said, I'm sort of here for a specific purpose, but otherwise we could just talk about anything if you want. I guess I could just say stuff. Since I'm online, I might as well just say some stuff, but I'm not even sure if it's worth it because I wasn't streaming for the first, I mean, I wasn't talking for the first 13 minutes here. Since
I don't remember which name.
Ah, okay.
I'm just that far right guy.
Oh, this is good. That far right guy. Okay, so this is perfect. That's perfect because this is exactly the sort of thing I need. So, what I've been saying is that I'm no longer act like a friend towards a person who you know, believes or acts in ways that I consider immoral. So pretty much anyone that would like be considered or consider themselves far right would sort of enter in that category. So this is good. So basically,
hey man, haven't seen you in ages.
Oh, some Sam 76. I don't remember that name very much, but apparently that's not a new name. Have you come here before under a different name? Or I'm sorry, otherwise my memory is bad, but usually I remember the people's names pretty, like the regular people I remember quite well. Okay, let's do this. Given that you believe in stuff that is presumably wrong, from
I was here on January 8th, 2022.
Okay. Okay. I have no recollection of January 8th, 2022 specifically, but wow. If you do, you must have an exceptional memory. So to all of those, so including you, so Shang Yang Gang, by nature of your beliefs, you are evil. At least partly. Obviously, there's a spectrum. Obviously, nobody's entirely non-evil because that would just, because to a certain extent, it's very hard to, or not, it's hard, it's very hard because you have to first have an idea
wow,
of what
that sucks.
Isn't evil. You have to have an idea of what isn't evil. So you could say that I was functionally evil for not knowing what was actually good before. And slowly I've become less and less evil, but at least in terms of my intent, I wasn't evil because I always wanted the best for everyone, right? So I think that's kind of the best way of determining at least who is in intent not evil. And far right is pretty hard to argue that your intent is the best for everyone, although I suppose some variants of that could fall under that category. Again, far right can mean lots of different things. So, yeah. And so, I don't know. Could it be? Let's see. I'm trying to think. What was that name? I'm trying to think of the names of these. How about Newman Leary? Or how about Newman? Is it that? Is it that Newman Leary? Is that your name? Or how about,
That's not me.
That's not you. Okay, so I don't know. I don't recall. How about Cottonmouth? Are you Cottonmouth? Or how about... Or are you just... Are you Shao? Are you Shao?
No, I'm not Cottonmouth.
Are you Shao?
Are you the Nathan from the iDiscord? Just curious.
I doubt it, because I don't know what that is. So, I don't know. So yeah, so you are evil, and as such, I cannot...
Am I who? Ask yourself, Discord.
I'm saying it in the French, Charles, pronounced with the French pronunciation. Ask yourself, Discord. No, I don't think so. So you're not Shao the...
Oh, the French nationalist guy? No, I'm not him.
Yeah, okay. Are you the
but
troll?
But I think I remember who you're speaking of.
Are you the troll? The seemingly Muslim or troll, but it's hard to know because it always sort of seems to morph into different guises. Sort of chameleon troll.
No, not Muslim.
Okay, but are you still the troll that pretends to be Muslim? Um, I can't think of anyone. That's like the only people I can think of. Man, I'm
I don't pretend to be Muslim.
Okay, so that's not you. That's not you either. Crap, I can't. So I can't.
Unless
remember.
Saying Inshallah counts.
No, that doesn't count. Okay, so I can't remember then. I can't remember other names. I probably would recognize the name, but okay. Well, anyway, so you are evil, and therefore, so I'm. This is my problem: is I shouldn't. I have this tendency to just, when I'm speaking to people, to just sort of have a sort of pretty neutral and even a bit friendly tone, and that I don't feel that's right. Like, you know, I should be more stern, but I don't really know how to do it. So that's what I'm saying. Like, you are presumably at least evil, and also anybody who believes in evil is also a fool or an idiot. So you're an evil fool, an evil idiot, and as such, I shouldn't be acting so friendly. I don't like this. Is what I don't understand. Why it's so hard? Why is it so hard to like? I don't know. Like, it just seems absurd. I can't sort of start growling and stuff, right? It like I'm not gonna start shouting. I'm not gonna start. I don't know. I don't know what to do. It's so hard. I can. What if I sort of whisper? You know, like when they're. Is sort of this tension, and you sort of go.
Are you a moral anti-realist?
Moral anti-realists? No, quite the opposite. I'm pretty much a moral realist in the sense of moral objectivist, but not completely. In as much as I think there's just, I think there are basic principles that of morality that are objective. And
utilitarian moral realist, I think.
Yes, exactly. So you remember well, exactly that. But then, of course, there are trade-offs, right? Like, one of the trade-offs is between the totality versus the fairness of distribution, right? So the question is, you know, is it fair to hurt someone to, you know, to make someone suffer to bring a lot of enjoyment to other people? So I would say if you hurt someone just a little bit to bring enjoyment to a lot of other people, then yes. But if you hurt someone a lot to bring a little enjoyment to a lot of other people, then no. But where exactly do you put the cutoff? So you see, in that sense, I think that there is some amount of moral, but it's not moral relativism so much as just a moral, an objective moral gray zone. But then there is, on the other hand, an objective morality outside of those gray zones, right? So like, if you increase the enjoyment of someone without decreasing anybody else's enjoyment, that's clearly objectively good, right? That's the way I see it. And then there's a few other values that I've added now, such as trying to minimize belief in falsehood. So like, I've decided to add that as another fundamental value, like trying to, yeah, anytime somebody believes in something that actually happens to be false, that should not be. So that's considered now a bad thing. I do recognize that is arguably not the case, but having thought of it, I've become convinced that still kind of should be considered. The main reason I've accepted to add that as a fundamental principle is precisely because there are these trade-offs. So obviously, if that principle is not going to affect enjoyment, then all other things being equal, all enjoyment being equal, then it's better for somebody to not believe in something false than to believe in something false, right?
Hey, waving hand from the land of pumpkins, Michigan. Call me Mac Jack-O-Lantern.
So apparently,
can you give an example of an objective moral good?
Okay, so first, Macaroon Granola. Apparently, you've been here before. I don't remember your name at all. But apparently, so I don't know. Can't really explain that. So hi, Mac. Some Sam76 can give an objective of example of objective moral good. Well, like I said, if you just increase the enjoyment of somebody, without decreasing anybody else's enjoyment or without violating these other principles in any other way, like without worsening things based according to these other principles, such as, you know, for instance, if you increase somebody's enjoyment by telling that person a lie, then because I've now considered belief in false, like minimizing belief in falsehood as a fundamental principle, therefore that would not be considered necessarily good. But if you just increase somebody's enjoyment without decreasing anybody else's enjoyment, and without, of course, increasing suffering and without increasing beliefs in falsehood, then that would be considered an objective moral good. Now, if you want a practical example, then that becomes maybe a bit more tricky, right? Because actually increasing somebody's enjoyment without decreasing anybody else's is actually really hard. Why? Because, like, for instance, you can maybe increase somebody's enjoyment by giving a present, right? But that present would require producing stuff, and that producing stuff would create externalities, would create harm, like, to the environment, which indirectly would harm people and stuff. And so it's not very necessarily obvious how to increase somebody's enjoyment without decreasing somebody else's. But I think a good example is where there'd be no production, right? So for example, if you just are really nice to somebody and that makes that person happy and it makes you happy too to do that, then there's no obvious loser there. There's no obvious third party that's going to be harmed. So in that case, that would be a clear objective moral good, right? So that's sort of the way I would say it. I mean, to me, it just seems intuitively obvious. This is actually an axiomatic principle, which means that it's not derived from any more
and
fundamental
principle.
And
by good,
you
mean preference.
By good, I mean good. By good, I don't mean preference. Preference is actually not, according to me, a fundamental principle. It's more a secondary principle, in as much as typically satisfying the preference of people will then tend to increase their enjoyment. But no, by good, I just mean, again, that is axiomatic too. You can't define good by some more fundamental concept. So the definition of good, there isn't a more fundamental definition, so you can't really define it. So you can only induce it. You can only go backwards. You go from some specific examples, and then you sort of backtrack to find the original principle. And so, yeah, good. I can't define good. Good is good. And good is enjoyment, is maximizing enjoyment, with the caveats I have listed. And you just have to accept that, and you have to acknowledge it. And it's like with math, they're also axioms, right? I don't remember them, but I remember they're like these
are you vegan?
Fundamental axioms of math. Am I vegan? No. Because it's not actually clear that is objectively good. With an obvious reason being that veganism, well, let's put it this way, meat eating, what does it do? It actually tends to harm the environment. What does harming the environment do? It tends to reduce the numbers of animals in the wild. And the thing is that most animals in the wild actually tend to suffer. And they likely suffer more than they have enjoyment. And even if not, they do tend to suffer like extreme amounts, especially when they're dying. And
I think that
result,
the real reason that Hillary Clinton lost the 2016 election was because of the horrible
animals.
Movie that came out before the election titled The Martian starring Matt Damon.
Okay. Okay, so you're one of these people that sort of say funny stuff that's sort of slightly, I don't know how to put it, but okay. You sort of remind me of various people that have come on before, so you might be someone that I've seen before under another name.
Have you heard of the NTT?
I don't know.
Name the trait. Argument for veganism.
No, I don't know that argument. But why do you think that Martian's a horrible movie? Just tell me what NTT is. But that's why it's not actually clear that veganism is better. If we could produce meat artificially. Not just that. If you could produce meat artificially and you eliminate all animals from the wild, then you should be a vegan, right? We're pretty far from that now. So that's my position. Okay, going back to what I was saying before. So, anybody who has evil beliefs. I don't want to go over this because it's always going to do the same thing. This is what I've actually been trying to do.
What trait present in humans, if present in animals, would not justify murdering and torturing animals?
What trait present? Okay. I'm trying to understand what you're. Okay, what trait present in humans, if present in animals, would not justify murdering and torturing animals? Okay, yeah, okay. The capacity to suffer. I mean, obviously, that's the, you know, that's from based from the thing that from my principle, right, of what I call enjoyism, which is what is generally called utilitarianism, right? It's the capacity to suffer, or also just to enjoy, which is to me suffering is just negative enjoyment. So
animals, you know, can suffer though.
Yeah, they can.
Muted.
But muted. I'm muted. No, I'm not muted. I can see that I can see that the sound is on. Yeah, that's
MB.
MB? What do you mean MB? I can see that there the mic thing is. I can see that I've got the mic thing.
My bad. Laughing face.
Okay. Okay. Yeah.
Descriptively, it is not that simple. It is a conglomeration of characteristics that signal relative genetic similarity / dissimilarity.
I'm not sure what you mean by that, Shan Yang Yang. What is a conglomeration of characteristics? You mean the capacity to suffer?
It's a horrible movie because it takes place in the useless orb of wasteland called Mars, and she expressly advocated for NASA's plan to human colonize it while Trump was advocating jobs.
Okay, that makes more sense. Okay, so I wasn't aware
that which distinguishes humans from animals to human supremacist animal product consumers.
Okay, so going on the animal thing, so, yeah, torturing, the thing is that you have to consider not just the active, but the passive. That's to say that if you have the power to prevent torture in the wild of animals by other animals, and you don't do it, you are actually torturing them. See, that's the thing. That's from a consequentialist perspective like mine. It doesn't matter if you're the active agent or the passive one. It's the same thing. Right. If you let somebody else torture somebody, or if you do it yourself, it makes no difference. Right. So that's the thing. The reason I can justify torturing animals for raising for meat is because by destroying the environment, it actually might mean having less animals being tortured by other animals or just by the environmental conditions in the wild. Right. So in fact, I'm actually lessening the total amount of torture, the total amount of suffering of animals. Right, that's how you can justify meat eating currently, right? That is the justification. In fact, that is. Otherwise, I kind of would have to be vegan because it would be pretty hypocritical. Although, I mean, there's the other things. I think it probably is better for my health to eat a moderate amount of animal products, and that could arguably be worthwhile also just for that, especially if. So ignoring the whole in the wild argument, if that had no impact at all, if like meat raising, meat production had no impact on the amount of animals in the wild, then you could still have an argument that's better for your health. And if they're really well treated while they're being raised, then it wouldn't be really much of a problem. It might even be beneficial, right? They might actually have a net positive life. And so even then, it's not necessarily clear that it's better to be vegan. Okay, so now the Mars thing. Yeah, so I'm not an advocate for Mars colonization because I don't, like you say, it's a wasteland. It could potentially be terraformed, but we're not there yet, and it would be just a huge waste of resources to try to terraform it right now, I think. I might be mistaken. I haven't looked into it really enough to be sure, but that would be my impression. So definitely not now. In the long term, of course, I do advocate for more colonization of other planets or other solid, rocky, spherical bodies, but meaning like, you know, moons around other planets, like in Avatar, not currently. Like currently, that's it's way too early for that. And So I agree that that is not a good thing to support currently. Trump advocating jobs, jobs, jobs. Well, I don't agree with that. I mean, it's not like there's all that much difference. And on the other hand, Trump was advocating was sort of there's lots of sort of nastiness in Trump's stuff, like other stuff, other policy and rhetoric and stuff. So I really don't think we should be celebrating Trump. If you're just talking about the rhetoric, if Trump is talking about jobs, then sure, jobs, I guess, is good, right? I mean, it is good, right? If you're just looking at the rhetoric, if Trump was in rhetoric talking more about jobs and Clinton was talking more about Mars colonization, then yeah, I agree. The jobs is a better thing. It's a more important thing. And from that perspective, it's understandable that that would be the winning candidate. Sure. Okay. So that being said, so returning still to my original objective of this session is, like I'm saying, for some reason, I'm still just talking very neutrally and friendly, which is not what I should be doing. But at least it gives me the satisfaction to realize that I wasn't just doing it because I was being like weak and sort of malleable and, you know, trying to kowtow to like to everyone here. But it's just that's sup, really homie. Hard. Hello, Senator Kira. Do I know you too from another name? Again, I don't recognize this name. But anyway, hi. My point is that at least that way I know that I wasn't really doing it like that. And it's just because it's really hard to speak in any other way.
I hear
the
you
way
like holocausting animals. LOL.
How do I like, so you're two vegans, so Sum Sam and Senator Kira, you're two vegans, and I'm presuming that Shanyang Gang and Macaroon Granola, if you're still here, that you're probably non-vegan, given that you seem to be sort of more pro, like, quote, right-wing, which seems to generally be associated with not being, with being sort of pro-meat-eating, I'm presuming.
Why don't you debate someone on it, RN? I was a vegetarian for about 10 years.
Macaroon Granola, thank you
not
for
vegan,
following.
Though.
Okay,
vegetarian,
so...
LMFAO.
Thank you for following, Senator Kira. LOL. What are you saying, vegetarian LMFAO?
Don't eat meat most days.
Wait, so Sam, you're not a vegetarian? So are you? Or were you just sort of arguing as from the perspective of a vegetarian or a vegan, but not? But you're actually
I'm
not
right
wing. At
all? I vote Green Party. I'm a radical unicyclist.
See, when you add "I'm a radical unicyclist," that makes me think that you're probably not being serious. But who knows? Who knows? You still don't... Okay, so...
Vegetarianism doesn't make any sense. Might as well eat might at that point.
Might as well eat... might? I guess you mean meat, but... I don't see how... Why does it not make sense? Oh, you mean vegetarian and not vegan. That's what you mean. Okay. Yeah. Because you're still, like, consuming animals. Well... You could say that you're still consuming less. So, I mean, I agree that being just vegetarian, like being just a strict vegetarian, but like, and
then
not being...
Will you debate professional career philosopher on veganism?
Yeah, sure. I mean, I'm not afraid to. I'm just not sure I've had the motivation. But like, if you've got a professional career philosopher right now that's willing to debate me on veganism... Sure, I can do it. I guess you want me to go on Discord?
I'll shoot you a Discord link.
I haven't been on Discord in over a year.
At Sumsum76y.
But,
I gotta go get breakfast. See ya next time.
Okay, sure. See you. Enjoy your breakfast. Like I said... Yeah, why does vegetarian not make sense? I'm gonna answer to Sumsum. it's because you're still exploiting animals, or you're still making animals suffer in the same way that you would as a regular meat eater, right? Because you're still like eating eggs, and that means that you're going to have like factory chickens and stuff. I agree that it doesn't make sense. Like, you might as well just be a regular meat eater, but just eat less meat, right? And you'd have a similar effect. So it's true that it doesn't make sense to be a strict vegetarian and then not care
Can
about
I post
like,
a link
how
here?
Much, how many eggs and stuff and milk you eat. You can post a link here, sure. Okay, so I'm going to go on Discord if I can remember how the heck that works. Because again,
and farming kills animals as well, so if you're a vegan you may as well eat meat. Just so you know, these people are actual intellectual heavyweights there. https://discord.gg/kwwad3swcw.
Wait. Oh, and by the way, if you don't want to hear the sound of the link, or then you can add an exclamation point, an exclamation mark at the beginning of your post, and then it won't the speech chat won't say it. Okay, select all the images with bicycles. Okay, oh crap. Oh, I guess I'm a robot. Oh no. Okay, I'm not a robot. Good. Accept the cookies, Discord. Here we go. Oh yeah, gotcha. See? It works. Okay, so I'm going to go on the Discord right now, but so what are you saying? Open Discord in my browser. Log in. Now I've got to figure out what the
Every
heck
green name there is a vegan who will defend their position from a philosophical viewpoint till death.
Okay, wait, I just gotta sign on. I didn't even know this. Do I have an account with that?
I think due to capitalism and people earning money from the sale of meat that we are constantly brainwashed by the industry told that we need it.
I don't think it's the industry. I think it's generally better for our health because there are lots of nutrients that are actually more absorbable in meat, and lots of like, and especially like, you know, B12, which they like literally, click on the head of the animal. Okay, I clicked on the head of the cat. Okay, I'm clicking on the head of the horse. Click on the head of the horse. Upside down horse. New login detected. Please check your email. Oh man, this is such a hassle. I'm sorry, but yeah. So if somebody wants to write stuff, you can, because it's true that as a result, it's kind of hard for me to discuss while I'm trying to get logged in here.
ITLL be worth it.
If somebody wants to discuss stuff about veganism, I can, but like. Oh, wait, crap. Oh, I didn't pass it. Oh, they're all giving me these crappy captchas. Oh, it's because I'm on a VPN. This is really annoying. Okay. So you're being constantly brainwashed by the industry. Look, I think that hear what I said? Like, isn't that convincing to you? Like, the fact that there's, you know, a lot of animals that are actually killed. Let's see if this works. They keep doing the CAPTCHA thing. But... This is such a pain.
I posted your link there.
Incorrect. Login credentials.
I'm one of those flexi people where 2 out of 3 meals today were classified vegan. The third would have been if it wasn't for those 2 slices of bacon. On day 3 I had a bit more meat. Day 4 I had none, like when you say you eat meat, people think you're scoffing 1 kilogram of chicken every meal.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I agree with that, that you can just eat less meat, and that's already helpful. For some reason, I'm not able to log in here. I'm not sure why. This is weird. Oh yeah, because I screwed up there. Okay, this time it's gonna work, but I think I'm not gonna. It's not gonna work. That's the problem, is that this is then really boring and then everybody leaves.
Why are you on a VPN?
For a reason that I cannot say. Okay. So apparently my Discord.
Long time no see. How is NZ? Did you meet a GF?
Okay, hi. NZ's all right. Long time no see. No girlfriend. That's impossible. So, nope. Nope. Okay, so that didn't work. I have no idea how to get on Discord.
How long you been studying philosophy for?
I haven't really studied it. Thought about it. I've been thinking about it for a few years, like about 3 years mostly, but you know, obviously I was thinking
I've been trying to get a girlfriend with Tinder and it's working somewhat.
And it's working.
Have you
somewhat.
Tried it?
Yes, I have. That does not work for me. Okay, I can't manage to get on. So I'm gonna have to create a new account. A new Discord account, but I think I maybe just won't bother doing a Discord thing for now, because it's a bit of a hassle for me here. I'm just trying that, but yeah. If anybody wants to argue about something else, I'd be glad to like do some filler for the stream. Of course, this was not even the intention of my stream, so this is the thing I'm getting sidetracked into this. I'm getting sidetracked so much. It probably would be good to have a Discord, so, and apparently. On the thumbnail, that is not a fruit. Is this correct? Okay, I'm on Discord, but now I have a new Discord, so okay. Okay, I finally got a Discord, a new one. Now I've just got to change that in my thing. Discord, so. Okay. Saved. And I am on Discord here. Oh wait, I still gotta add one more thing. Okay, I'm on Discord. And you put a link. Is anybody here still? Oh yeah. Copy. Paste. Study archives. Okay, but is there? I have to verify my account. And this is just a waste of time here. I feel like I'm. Is this working now?
Just introduce yourself and someone will message you to debate.
Okay, so I've done this. I probably shouldn't have done this, actually.
These people are hungry for vegan debates.
I thought it would be I'm not gonna ask for a debate right now. Maybe
is it vegan games channel?
If we're gonna Okay, apparently I do not have permission to send messages in this channel though. Unfortunately, that's what it says. But maybe it's because I wasn't verified, but now I am verified. But I don't know. But yeah, it says I.
Dr. Avi Bitterman's Discord.
Yeah, I see Avi. Yeah, Avi Bitterman.
Oh my goodness, if it's vegan gains, you're gonna get roasted. Careful, Nathan XD. He's friends with Ask Yourself and Vegan Gains.
Okay, why would I get roasted? Look, don't you want to just discuss things myself, like yourselves with me? Like, it says I don't even have permission to message them, so I, or apparently that's welcome, so maybe there's somewhere else that I have permission, but I don't know then which thing I would be supposed to. Rules. What's the rules here?
They're extremists, like they will go hard on you severely.
Okay, but why would I even do that? Like, extremists.
Go to general.
Oh yeah, general. Wait, but this is a voice channel. Like, I'm literally connected.
General
right now.
Text chat, I mean.
Oh crap! How do I get off of here? How to disconnect. Okay, so disconnected. What? And the problem is that you can't see. Look, okay, I'm gonna add the screen thing so you can see me. Display capture. Okay. Just hope that you don't see secret classified information. Well, yeah, like my inbox here, which. Okay. Where do I go? Like, the thing is, I don't want to debate with like extremists and stuff. They're not gonna want to have a proper debate anyway. They're not gonna look. Why don't you debate me, or like debate me on Discord or something instead? Why don't you introduce
yourself in general?
But in the voice thing, because this is like a voice. It's a voice thing, it's not a text thing, and there's nobody else there on the voice thing in general.
Text one.
There's no text
below.
General. I don't. Open text channel? Oh, this one. Okay, sorry. You're right.
Veganism is horrible. From a nutritional and life quality perspective, even a lot of animals aren't vegan.
Look, why do you want me to debate? Why do you want me to do this? Okay, no, look, in any case, I wasn't here to debate. I wasn't here actually to. I shouldn't have been doing this. Okay, precisely. I'm also here. Basically, the whole point of my streaming right now is actually to say that would be less of a pushover, or at least seem less of a pushover, in as much as I feel that I have been seeming like a pushover.
Every debate they have, they follow
thinking.
Logic and debate mechanics to a T.
Okay. Yeah, I maybe don't do that. I mean, I follow logic, but I don't like follow, like, I don't have a structure that I've learned, you know, so, but like, I'm not afraid of debating them, but let's just go back. What I actually was streaming here for is that I was saying that everybody that is immoral that has beliefs that I would consider immoral and has had time to think about it and still clings to those beliefs is evil. I think that's the case of almost everyone, so I think almost everyone is evil. That's the case also of my viewers, so almost all my viewers are evil. Therefore, you, my viewers here, are evil. And anybody who is evil is actually also irrational, and meaning that they're also a synonym I like to use to be more provocative is an idiot, and so therefore you're evil idiots.
I'm not evil.
Well, that's arguable. I don't know. But anyway, just to have this said, and also as a result, we can't be friends. We aren't friends. And basically, if you think I'm friendly, that's just an illusion. It's just because I don't know how else to talk. But actually, I don't like you, or probably wouldn't like you if I actually knew you more. And so there, but it feels less hard to say it now that there's several people, because it doesn't feel like I'm addressing anyone in particular. I think it's the hardest if I had like a regular viewer, that I had a harder time when there's just one person, and especially one person that I knew. But I feel the need to say this. I feel the need to make it clear. Okay, this is not, I'm not here, I'm not your buddy, I'm not your friend, I'm not anybody's friend. I don't have friends in real life either, by the way, for the same reason. Although, well, not directly for the same reason. I mean, I wouldn't have friends for the same reason, but the real reason is that other people don't want me to have me as a friend. So initially I was rejected by others, but then I realized that I actually would reject others too.
LUL.
Now. So there we go. So anyway, having said that,
are you evil?
I'm less evil. I'm the least evil person on Earth, probably. The least evil animal, the least evil living organism on Earth, probably. In a sense. But I couldn't say that I'm completely unevil. I mean, it's hard. In a way, yes, you could say at least conceptually, intellectually, I'm close to being completely unevil. Emotionally, I am still evil in the sense that I sometimes...
You're fine with murdering animals.
I'm not fine with murdering animals. I precisely stated that I support meat eating in as much as it actually means less animals are hurt, right? So that, I mean, you could say that I'm fine with murdering them initially, but as to not make them suffer. So no, it's not, I'm precisely, I think that
most animals have small brains and aren't self-aware.
Yeah, but I mean, the fact that they have small brains aren't self-aware doesn't matter. They're still conscious, right? They don't have this sort of extra self-awareness. I mean, they have an instinctive self-awareness, right? They just don't have this extra degree of more conceptual self-reflection, right?
How do you know they're conscious?
I presume. Of course, we don't know. We don't know for sure, but how do I know? I can't know anybody else except for myself is conscious either, right?
They still have sentience.
I can't know that any other human is conscious. They might just look conscious, but they might just be completely off, right? There's no way to know that. There's no way to know that. But it seems, I mean, presumably...
Seems about as likely as other humans being conscious. Yeah.
Yeah. The question is, like, really primitive ones. Like, is, like, a jellyfish, is that conscious? You know, I don't know.
Know you're conscious either.
No, you can know you're conscious. I mean, I can't. I am conscious, right? That's like the sort of Descartes thing, though. I'm not sure if that's what Descartes meant, but, you know, I think, therefore I am.
I know I'm conscious.
It's like, you know you're conscious because it's right here. Like, you're experiencing it. That's like the only thing you can know, in fact, is your own consciousness and the contents of your consciousness. That's the only thing you can know for sure, but you can know that for sure. Right. But I don't know how to explain it more than that. I mean, that's just self-evident. There's not really anything else. There's not really anything I can do with more to explain that.
Show me your epistemic penis if you're so sure you're real.
I'm not even sure what you mean. What does that mean?
LUL.
What do you... Okay, so you really want me to do this? You really want me to do the... Like, the thing is that, again, I'm not even streaming. I'm streaming just to make that point, and I'm not actually... Again, I'm confident that I will never become successful enough on my own.
You might be a brain in a vat, controlled by a supercomputer.
Sure, I might be that, but my consciousness, I as a consciousness, still exist as a consciousness, right? So, obviously...
That's still consciousness.
Yeah, my impression of the world might actually just be a simulation, but it's still real, just like when you're playing a video game. Like, your own immersion, the environment, is still real, like when you're dreaming, actually, right? It's still, your experience of it is real, even if it doesn't have a reality beyond that, right? So in that sense, it's still real. And that's the only thing.
What you're arguing is just that the conscious experience might not be reflective of the true nature of the external world, not that you can't be sure you're conscious. What do you mean by real?
Real is just, again, that's a sort of an axiomatic concept, a fundamental concept that you can't really define in any other way. Like, it's something that exists. It does exist. Your consciousness exists. I mean, I'm not sure how to define it any other way. It is. Like, there are these impressions. I'm seeing right now my computer screen. I'm seeing the colors of the red of Shang Yang Gang and the blue of Senator Kira, you know, and it's an impression. That impression is real. Regardless of whether or not there's some sort of external reality that it corresponds to, that it seems to correspond to. Maybe it does that, maybe it doesn't exist, right? But the experience of it is an experience, and like there is an experience, therefore it's real. I don't know how to say it in any other way. I don't know how to say it in any other way. I have to say, I'm gonna have to edit this now. Oh no. Okay. Okay. Well, look. Anyway, I've done this. It's gonna be even more complicated to do this if I stop this. So if I don't stop this. So okay, I'm stopping the stream. I'm also kind of tired. Thanks for coming by. I think I've discussed enough that I needed to do so. And now this is gonna be annoying. I'm gonna have to edit my video. Yeah. Thanks for coming by. And.